here at the Living Planet Aquarium in Sandy, Utah. I'm in an instrumentation class. This is just a little ROV, remotely operated vehicle.
It's got a motor in there, runs off DC power.
We're experimenting to see how this shark in a smaller enclosed system would react to the sub before we introduce the sub into our larger system where we have 8 more sharks and a green sea turtle. It really doesn't seem to impact it at all. So we're gonna go ahead and try it in the bigger tank with more sharks and see how they respond. Well, we put the sub in the water. When we first put it in, the turtle was a little bit curious. This is our rescued green turtle. She was found in a canal in Florida. She'd been bitten by a shark and hit by a boat. She's not able to submerge on her own. We have this weight pack on its back that we can add lead weights to.
The original idea was to build an arm, a mechanical arm, to kind of clean the back of the sea turtle. This was like the stage one of testing, just kind of see what would happen if we got close to the turtle.
This gave the animals a chance to see something new, to think, to stimulate their minds. And it also let us test this technology. Recently, there have been some two-man submersibles for deep sea animal collecting, and they use a similar technology where they use the suction device on a sub to actually try to collect shrimp or small fish from those deep areas that divers can't access.
It'd have to be a little more complex device. We could definitely get samples of soil.
In an aquarium, especially where sharks are concerned, it's really hard to do any veterinary procedures. Something like a blood draw. If we could get enough dexterity with a sub like this, maybe we wouldn't have to take an animal out of the exhibit. I think this was a good experiment. We try to provide enrichment for the animals, and this is definitely an enriching opportunity.